And these are today's shoutouts. If you want to see yourself in the next video, then subscribe and leave a comment. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Arca here, and I'd like to ask you a favor. If you find this video useful, please do make sure to subscribe to my channel. Help me grow, and I'm starting to gift subscribers. More info at the end of the video. Please enjoy. What is up, boys? Arca here, and today I'll tell you how to reduce your input delay and the lag in Fortnite. This guide is going to be really useful because it will cover everything from hardware things that you can improve to in-game related issues. But before we begin, I really want to point out that we are growing so blazingly fast, it's amazing to record these videos for you on the daily. So if you enjoyed these videos that cover how you can improve at the game, increase your performance, reduce input delay, and other competitive stuff like that, then consider hitting that subscribe button and joining the hype squad. But this is it for the plug. I hope you boys enjoy this video and let's jump right in. So first point of this video is to make sure that the hardware you use is not limiting you. And by that I mean your controller, and like how you can use it wired or unwired. And also if you're using a gaming monitor. And if you're on a TV, then are you like using the right settings mode for it and everything in between. So yeah, but the most important thing people tend to overlook in these things is that everything adds up. You could have like a 1 milliseconds response time monitor, but your controller would be lacking with 10 milliseconds because you're using it incorrectly. And to prove my point, here is a graph that shows how much response time you're adding to your game because of the type of monitor you're using. So they're converting the mass response time of monitors into live FPS. And here is another image that shows the response time of different keyboards. And if you look at the top, gaming keyboards aren't there. Yeah, the Razer Ornata is bang on in the middle at 35 milliseconds. That is a big reaction loss compared to the top dogs. And here is another image that shows you the input delay you get from using different refresh rate monitors. Like you may have one MS, 60Hz, and a 120Hz monitor. But did you know the 120Hz monitor will have a 45 milliseconds response time advantage in video games? And after that, you also have the gaming mode settings to worry about. Like if your monitor uses Radeon anti-lag technology with VSync turn off, it will be better than VSync turned on. But yeah, I just threw in a lot of these things to make you understand that if you try to improve your monitor or controller's input delay, it will make you play better and it will make a difference. Because look at all of this stuff, it all adds up. You get your monitor, keyboard, turn on VSync, and there you have it, like a 300 milliseconds total response time delay. And if you didn't know, the average human reaction time when playing games is like 150 to 250 milliseconds. And imagine going up against someone when you have 150 plus brain reaction speed plus 300 MS, which is hardware related, which is 450 milliseconds in total. And the guy you're fighting has the best equipment out there, and even though he has like 250 milliseconds reaction speed, which is lower than your, he still beats you because he has better equipment. Like, that's unfair, and this video will help you overcome that. So I hope you got my point, but this video is gonna focus on the more easy and manageable parts that you can actually change. And that is, how do you use your controller? Because if you look at this graph, then you can see the PS4 controller on Bluetooth only has 2.8 milliseconds response time, while the same PS4 controller, but with a wired connection, will need 10 milliseconds. That is a big jump, but don't worry, Xbox players. Your connection speed doesn't change. It stays at the same 6 milliseconds regardless if you're wired or on Bluetooth. But yeah, you need to know when you are at a disadvantage. If you want to hop on for a quick game, but your controller is dead from yesterday, plug it in and wait a few minutes before jumping in to play. Let it charge with the wire and then unplug it to have the fastest connection speed possible. And onto the second point of this video, the monitors. Like if you're using a TV, then boys, make sure to have it on the gaming mode. That is a setting
every TV has. Like, if you go into your TV settings and see that it has all these different view modes but not named gaming, then it is just hidden somewhere. I had a TV like that, and what you need to do is navigate into your settings and scroll down until you see something with the same meaning, like change settings. Because I can guarantee you that every monitor has a gaming mode. It's just that on some TVs, it's hidden in the deep settings and not shown on the quick access bar, where you just press one button and scroll through available modes. And that is an absolute must, by the way. If you're on a TV, they average around 90 milliseconds. That is big time. Like, I don't know how you can even play games like that. When you turn on the gaming mode for the TV, you get 10 milliseconds on average, which is a really, really good improvement and also near perfect. Like, all the monitors used to be 10 milliseconds until they started making gaming ones, and the normal ones are still a lot better today with their 10 milliseconds response time on average now. And that is just fine, like, you don't have to sweat it. It's only 10 milliseconds. And you're at a disadvantage, because a lot of people use their PC's monitors and they are like 6 milliseconds if they aren't like the expensive ones but the cheaper ones. So we covered the controllers and also the monitors, but what about the game itself? And here I'll split the topic into two and talk about the two different platforms, PCs and consoles. And I'm gonna start with the PC because it's quicker. So if you're on console, you can skip a bit ahead or watch this too in case you ever find yourself thinking of buying a PC to game on as well. So for the PC, what you want to do is make sure your PC is not being overworked and used by something else while you're gaming. Like, no background processes. Check your task manager and make sure to stop anything you don't need, like Spotify or YouTube, because Chrome, especially YouTube, take up a lot of your RAM and also processing power. So turning off will give you a boost in the input delay, because your PC can focus on the game faster and nothing else. And there is also a really simple trick, but it works only for 60Hz gamers. So if you're on PC and only have 60Hz monitor, let's say you're playing on Full HD, that's 1920 by 1080p resolution, right? And no matter your PC, if you have like 100 frames on that resolution, then you know that you can increase your input delay by a lot. Like, a lot. All you need to do is turn down the res to 1600 by 900. That is slightly lower and it will be noticeable because of the blurry textures and corners. But don't worry, try running around with that res for one or two games, and I think the first thing you will see is that your PC feels a lot faster and smoother. And yeah, this is all from personal experience as well, guys. Like, these are hard proven facts by me. I used to get 100 plus frames on all the games, but I would deliberately turn down the res down a bit because, to put it simply, your monitor and the PC are not in sync. Like, your computer might be outputting those 100 frames, but the monitor refreshes at different pace. And while the PC is trying to push those 100 frames, your monitor may skip a few of them of the 60 it works on. And that's because it simply misses the time frame. The PC or monitor may be ahead of each other by like a fraction of a second, even as low as 4 milliseconds, which is enough for you to lose a whole frame. So when you turn down the resolution to 1600 by 900, although you can perfectly still run the game at Full HD, you will get those benefits of reducing input delay on the 60Hz monitor. And for the consoles, if you have apps like YouTube or Twitch open in the background, make sure to close them. That is because they are still open and used a little bit by your RAM. If they aren't completely closed, they will use some of your power to be quickly powered back on again, and we don't want that. And if you also got a ton of games you don't play on your hard drive, then uninstall them to free up some space and let the console have a breather. But the most important thing I'd say you could do is get an SSD. Like, the HDD you got is bad. I changed mine to an SSD and saw faster load times, processing times, and everything works quicker and faster. So do it if you haven't yet. But this is it for this video. I hope you guys found it useful. If you did, then hit that subscribe button with the notification bell not to miss any of my new videos that I may upload. I'm making daily videos, so if you want to improve and get better with me, let's go on this journey together. But yeah, I hope I'll see you guys in the next one, and as always, peace.
Hey guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoy and find it useful. If you want to join my future Battle Pass and V-Box giveaways, do make sure to easily apply by subscribing and leaving an account with your Fortnite username. I will be choosing 5 random people in the near future for weekly gifts. Peace.